Are you like me, forgetting where you put those songs inside your iPod? Hi, I'm Rokosz, your digital lifestyle expert, and I'm going to show you some tips and tricks on how to arrange music on your iPhone or iPod so you can find it. First thing we want to do here is hook up your iPod to the computer using the iPod cable and the USB into the USB port on the computer. Then we want to launch our iTunes program. And then you can see right here in the library, this is your master breakdown of everything that's happening. Okay? And you can see it's arranged by name, time, artist, album, genre. But let's say you want to get a little bit more detailed and a little bit more information on how you put things into your, you know, into your system so you can find them. One thing you can do here is right-click or control-click, go to Get Info, and it's going to launch this little splash page here of all the different types of information. Here's the summary, all little, all the encoding bits and pieces of it, its time. Some deeper info in here will show you, well, who's the album artist? Here's the name of the album. You can create a grouping for it. The composer, you can put in comments. You can decide if it's part of a compilation. Then during the sorting function, you can decide, hey, you know, the actual composer is this guy, but I want to sort it. I want it to know that it's the Beastie Boys. It should be the artist, the album, the composer. I want them to all be the Beastie Boys. And also, too, it does break things down by all the letters. So, you know, a lot of times if I'll take the composer here and I'll break it down and make it match the actual name. Not, I don't like to call them the Beastie Boys. I like to just call them Beastie Boys, all right? And that's just personal. Options over here, you can adjust the volume on it so it can really jam out in your car. Be careful to not over-modulate. And you can manage artwork over here. Now, that makes it a little bit easier to find things because it's got some more information. Another great way to doing it is the rating. All I'm doing here is sliding it and creating stars. Now, in my library, I don't use the stars for 5 being my favorite, 1 being my least favorite. The way I use them is that each star, whether 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, means something different. So I like to do it where 5 stars are my audiobooks. You know, 1 stars are the latest music. You can create a code there, or probably the easiest way of arranging things, and you can do this in several different ways, is move them into either customized, like my jams down there, and now you can put in, you know, this song into as many different playlists as you want to. To create a playlist, you just simply hit the plus button down here, call the playlist whatever you'd like, hit the return there, and go back to your music, and you can see over here, and it just begins to drag and drop. You can make as many different ones as you want, and it's just that easy. So those are some ways that you can arrange music to make it easier to find in your iPod. I'm Rokosz, your digital lifestyle expert, saying, stream you later.